Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mitesh Gala. Welcome to Roughbook, a learning companion.
Simultaneous equations and exercise 6A, let's try and understand. So let us consider an equation which is the degree as 1. So if this is my equation, this can be expressed as AX plus BY equals C, right? So when you express an equation in this format, where the degree of the equation is just 1, right? And you write one more equation like that in the same format. So these two equations together are termed as simultaneous equations. Alright, one equation is a linear equation, and when two linear equations are there together, linear equation means the degree is 1 with one or more variables. So here I can see two variables, and when two variables and two linear equations are there and you are trying to solve both of them together, then such equations are called as simultaneous equations. Why simultaneous? Because you are trying to solve x and y, two variables, simultaneously. Since you are trying to solve them simultaneously, we call such as simultaneous equations. Now, how to solve simultaneous equations? There are four methods. Method 1 is called as elimination by substitution. I'll explain the methods one by one. First, let's understand. Method 2, by equating the coefficients. Method 3 is called as cross multiplication method. And method 4 is graphically. Okay, now let's look at all the methods. First one, elimination by substitution. Elimination means you are eliminating one of the variables, either x or y. How are you doing eliminating? By substituting. That means you will substitute one equation in the other one. How to do that? We'll come to that. Second method, equating the coefficients. Coefficients are the numbers before the variable. So when you are eliminating one of the coefficients, how will you eliminate? You will equate them. To equate them, you can multiply the equations by a certain numbers. And when you multiply them, equate them, you can cancel one of the variables. So that method is called equating the coefficients. How to do it? We will go on to that in the next exercise, not in this video. The next one is cross multiplication. Cross multiplication is a different method where we use the determinants, that is D. So how to go about that? That will be in the third video from now. Right? And the last one is graphically. Graphically is using the graphs. This we are not going to do in this chapter. This we are going to do in another chapter called as coordinate geometry or graphical solutions. In graphical solutions is what we are going to use simultaneous equations, solve them graphically. So right now we don't have to worry about this. We just have to do these three. Out of these three also, these two right now we need not focus. We are just looking at this one. So that's the ground plan. So your ground plan for this chapter are these three types. And the last type is word problems. Word problems, you got to frame the English language into mathematical language and then use any one of the methods whichever you are comfortable. So let us right now focus ourselves for the first method, elimination by substitution. That's our first exercise, 6A. So we got two equations and they say solve them by elimination by substitution method. So you pick up any one of the equations. Let's say if I pick up the first one, 8x 5y equals 9. The thumb rule is on the left hand side there should be only one variable, let's rest everything on the right hand side. In other words, either make x or y as your subject. So when you are making it as a subject, only that variable stays here, rest everything moves on to the other side. So 8x equals to 9 minus 5y, I push this on the other side, not even the coefficient, only the variable. So x is equal to 9 minus 5y upon 8. So I made x as my subject. Once I make x as the subject, substitute this in the second equation. So first name this as 1 and name this as 2. Now say let x be substituted in equation 2. This you can't substitute back in equation 1. If you do that, you will get nothing. Your answer will be 0. You will have to substitute in the other equation compulsorily. So 3x plus 2y equals 4. So 3 into x, x is 9 minus 5y upon 8 plus 2y equals 4. Now take the LCM. You can see only one variable left, that is y. So when you solve it, automatically what you will get is the answer to y. Once you get y, substitute the value of y here and you will get the value of x. So in short, what have I done? We've taken first equation, got in terms of x something, and that has been substituted in the other equation, and hence the name of the method, elimination by substitution. So you are eliminating, but how? By substituting. Okay, let's go ahead and get the answer to this one. So 27 minus 15y by 8. Pause your video and try on your own. Don't cheat from here. Okay, I'm taking the LCM here. So 27, 15y, 8 2s are 16 and 8 4s are 32. 15 minus 16, 1y, 32 minus 27 should give me 5. So we get the answer to y. Let's get the answer to x. So take this part. X is equal to 9 minus 5y upon 8. So x is equal to 9 minus 5 into y. Y is also 5 upon 8. So 9 minus 25 by 8. So 9 minus 25 shall give me 16, but negative 16. So my answer should be negative 2. So finally x is equal to minus 2 and y is equal to 5. How many managed to get the same answer to this one? Wow, that's good. If you got the same answer, it's amazing. Minus 2 and 5. Did you understand the method? Let's look at the method once again, and from the next sum onwards, we'll go at a better pace. We make any one, not necessary every time x has to be the subject. You can even make y as your subject. Whichever you make as a subject, substitute it in the other equation. And when you solve, you get one variable. Substitute back in this part only and you will get the second variable. In the end, don't forget to write the final answer together. The entire exercise is based on this concept only. There is nothing new now. If you followed this, you are capable of doing the entire exercise. Come on, everybody, sum number 3. Hit it. First, name. And now let's substitute one in the other. So let's make subject. So what are you making the subject? X. Okay. So 2x, 8 minus 3y. X is equal to 8 minus 3y upon 2. So we managed to get the value for x. Now substitute this in the other equation. So it is going to be, let x be substituted in equation 2. So x is equal to, 2x minus 3y equals 2. So 2 into x, x is 8 minus 3y upon 2 minus 3y equals 2. So this gets cancelled. So 8 minus 3y minus 3y 2 minus 6y. This goes on the other side, minus 6. So I get the value for y as 1. How many managed to get this? Not by copying, by doing it on your own. Cheaters, they raise their hand, they copy. So 8 minus 3y by 2. So 8 minus 3 into y is 1. So that will be 8 minus 3, 5 by 2. So x is 2.5 and y is 1. So we managed to get the two answers for sum number 3. How many got this?
Superb.
Yeah, you can actually be happy about it, because such type of sums are expected in the exam. So please try it. Okay,
come on, let's go to the next one. I want everyone to try sum number 5. Come on, pause the video and hit it.
So how are we going about with this one? So here we are lucky that this is already the subject with only one coefficient here. So I can directly say x is 7y plus 7 by 6, correct? And now put this in the second equation. So let x be substituted. So when we substitute, 7y minus x equals to 8. So 7y minus x, x is 7y plus 7 by 6 equals 8. So 6 is my LCM, so 6 sevens are 42y. Don't forget this minus sign, it's very dangerous if you don't give the correct treatment. So minus 7y plus into minus minus 7, and 6 eights are 48. So 42 minus 7 will give me how much? 35. 7 goes on the other side, it gets added, so I get 55. So what will be the value of y now? So my y will be 55 upon 35. 5 elevens are sorry, and 5 sevens. So the value of y becomes 11 by 7. Don't worry, it's correct answer, although it's unusual, but doesn't matter. Let's substitute it in the second part. So x is equal to 7y plus 7 by 6. So 7 into y. Y is 11 by 7 plus 7 by 6. 7, 7 goes. 11 plus 7, 18 by 6. So x becomes 3. So therefore x is 3 and y is 11 by 7. Yeah, one doubt may be in someone's mind. What if you take y as your subject? First you will get x, then you will get y. But the answers will remain the same. The answers will never change. So don't worry about that. Yeah. Let's go to the next one. Sum number 7. Come on. Again, make one of the variable as a subject and then substitute it. So taking the first one, 2x, 39 minus 7y. Come on, stop copying, guys. Stop copying. Go ahead on your own. Don't be cheaters. Pause the video. So I'll get x is equal to 39, 7y by 2. Once I got this, let's substitute this part in the other equation. So 3x, 5y, 31. So 3 into 39 minus 7 by 2 plus 5y. Put brackets so there is no confusion. LCM is 2, right? So opening here, 3 9s are 27, 9, 10, 11 minus 27y, 5 2s are 10 and 62. So this should give me minus 17. This goes on the other side, so minus. So 62 minus 117. So that becomes 55 negative. 5 plus 2 7 and 11, correct. So y is minus 55 by 17. Okay. How many of you have caught my mistake? Yeah, y'all are good. So the mistake is 3 9 3 7s are 21 and not 27. So 21 minus 10 shall give me 11 over here. So I'll get minus 55 by 11. So y is equal to 5. Yeah, you've caught my mistake. Good job. If you've not caught my mistake and you've also done the same mistake, means you've copied. Good way to check whether you're copying or no, isn't it? So x is 39 minus 7y by 2. So 39 minus 7 into y is 5 by 2. 39 minus 35 by 2, 4 by 2, so 2. So finally, x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 5. How many got the entire, both the answers correct without looking into the video on their own? Good job. Keep it up. Don't be cheaters like others. Sum number 9. Come on, do it please. You'll have to first simplify this. Take one of the equations, simplify it, push everything on the other side, make it as a subject and then substitute it in this directly. So I'm just opening it, 2x minus 6, 3y minus 15. It's not a difficult sum. It just looks like dangerous, but it isn't. So 2x I'm keeping here, rest everything I'm pushing there. So minus 3y, this is going to be minus 21, so plus 21. So x becomes minus 3y plus 21 by 2. Yeah. Taking the second equation and opening it directly, 5x minus 5, 4y minus 16. So I'll get 5x plus 4y minus 21. So minus 21 going on the other side, plus 21. Now let's substitute. So 5 into minus 3y plus 21 by 2 plus 4y, 21. Have I done any mistake till now? Tell me now, don't tell me later. Minus 51, 105 plus 4 2s are 8 and 42. So I am not taking any denominators. 15 and 8, so that should give me 7 negative. Going on the other side, so I'll have to subtract. So 3 and this should be 6. Let me check. 3 plus 2 5, 6 plus 4 10, but negative. So y becomes 9. How many got the same answer? Wow. Substitute this and get me the value of x. Come on everybody. So what will be my x now? So x is equal to minus 3y plus 21 by 2. So minus 3 into 9 plus 21 by 2. Minus 27 plus 21. So minus 6 minus 3. So x is minus 3 and y is 9. Any problems anybody? Everyone got the same answers? Yeah. I am sure everyone will get same answers because I know many of them, they are, the corner of the eye is always on the video only. Okay, anyone racing with me? Yeah, so don't pause the video, start with me. I hope neither you nor me, none of us make any mistake. lengthy question. You'll have to first take the LCM, make the subject, then substitute. So let's try. So I'm taking the LCM as 21. So this will be 3 times. So 3 twos are 6. See, when you take 21, you multiply each term by 21 in your head. 7 ones are 7, 3s are, so 3 into 2, 6 plus 3. 3 ones are 7s are, so 35, y and 21. And 21 into 12, so 12 ones are 12, 12 twos are 24, so 252. So 6x equals to minus 35y, and 21 plus 3 will give me 18 negative. 18 negative goes there, becomes positive. So plus 270. So x should be minus 35y plus 270 upon 6. Anyone managed to get the same? I am not really sure if I have got this correct. I am taking the LCM here also, 18, 18, 18. So let me see, 2 ones are 9s are. So 9 threes are 27x, 9 twos are 18, minus. 9 ones are 2s are, so 2 fours are 8. And plus into minus, don't mess that up, minus, 3 twos are 6. If you got this correct, now that means you have copied. Is equal to 13 into 18. So 13 into 18, 13 8s are 104, so 10, 23, 234, so I get 27x, 8y, 234, and this is going to be how much, 12, 12 going on the other side deduct, so 222, correct? Let's substitute now, so 27 minus 35y plus 270 by 6 minus 8y, 222, so 3 2s are, 3 9s are, correct? Now I can't cancel this further, so again LCM. So 9 5s are 45, 9 3s are 27 plus 4, that will be negative 31, so 315. 9 into 0 is 63, 6 9 2s are 18 plus 6 24, minus 8 2s are 16 and triple 4. I have no clue if I am on the right track or no, this will be Y. Let's see if we can manage. So 15 plus 16 is 31. So 331y, 444 minus this, so I'll have to subtract these two, put with a negative sign. So this is going to be 6, 9, so 8, 0, so 9 and 1. Let me check, 6 plus 4, 10, 12 and 1, 13, 13 and 1, 14 and 2. So y is, let's pray to God that we are on the right track, 331, negative gets cancelled. Does this go 6 times? 6 1s are 6, 6 3s are 18, 19. Wow, we managed to get it correct. Y is equal to 6. How many got this one correct? If you got it on your own, I am seriously impressed. Please tell me your name so that I really get impressed. Yeah. Substitute, get me the value of x. So x is minus 35 into 6 plus 270 by 6. So minus 35 or 6 5s are 30. 18, 19, 20, 21. So 210 plus 270 by 6, 60 by 6, so 10. So x is 10 and y is 6. Yeah, it was a tough question, but all of us together we managed to slay it. Chalo, let's go to the next one. Everyone clear? See, the sum is not tough, but lot of calculations in the sum. So I'm sure many cartoons over there must have not paused the video. They must have gone through the video, taken the calculations, and then they must have got the answer. If you got it that way, shame on you. Come on, go ahead, 13th. 13th is slightly different, so I don't want you to start straight away. First, pay attention. Here you got some denominators. So first take the LCM, then coefficient, on the other side everything, and then substitute. Okay, let's try it. So LCM is 6. If you still don't know how to take the LCM, see 2 3s are 6, so multiply each term by 6, 2 1s are 2 3s are, 3 1s are 3 2s are, nothing cancels. Now multiply and note denominators because you are multiplying everywhere by 6. Okay, 3 3s are 9x, 10y plus 12, 0. So 9x is 10y minus 12. So x is 10y minus 12 upon 9. So I got my first part. Yeah. Let's take the second part, x. Let's take the LCM part only straight away. So 6, 6, 6, right? So 3 1s are 3 2s are, so 2x. 2 1s are 2 3s are, so 3y. 6 cancel, but 6 2s are 12 and 1 13, 13 by 6, so 6 is gone. Now let's substitute, 2 times 10y minus 12 upon 9 plus 3y, 13, nothing cancels, so 20y, 24, 27, 9 into 13, 117, so 20y and 27, so it becomes 47, this goes on the other side, so I'll have to add 7 plus 4, 11, 213 and 141, I think I have done it correct, 7 plus 4, 11, 2, 3 and 1, 4 and 1. So y is 141 by 47. I really don't know whether the answer is going to be correct or no, so we'll have to think. So if I multiply by 3, 3 7s are 21, 12, 13, 14, super, we've got this also correct. Super job guys. Come on, let's go ahead, let's get the value of x. So x is equal to 10 into y, which is 3, minus 12 by 9. So 30 minus 12 should be 18 and therefore 2. So x is 2, y is 3. How many of you are getting all these sums correct? Good job. Come on, go to the next one, 14. I have picked up all the tough ones so that, don't look at the homework stating that this is the last sums, you're already rejoicing. First finish this, then we will rejoice all together. 16 and 15, 6 and 15, so LCM can be 30. Yeah. So 6 ones are 5s are, 15 ones are 2s are, and 30 into 4, 120. Let's make the subject x, 120 minus 2y. So x is 120 minus 2y by 5. Now let's substitute this in the other one. So the LCM I can see is 12 straight away. So 3 ones are 4s are, 12, 12 cancels, so only y. This is 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 by 4. But 4 ones are 4 threes are. So I'll have to multiply 19 into 3. Once again, 4 fours are 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 by 4, 12. So 4 threes are. So I'll have to multiply 3 into 19 as 57. Now let's substitute. So 4 times 120 minus 2y upon 5 minus y, 57. Again LCM 5. So 4 into 120, 480. Minus 8y, minus 5y, 35, 28, so 285. So what do I get now? 8 plus 5, 13y. This goes on the other side, so I'll have to subtract with the minus sign I'll have to put. So the difference is 195, I guess. 5 plus 5, 10. 8 plus 7, 17 and 1, 18. 2, 3 and 1, 4, correct. So y is minus 195 by 13. So 13 ones are 13. So what is left? 65. So 5 times. So I get the value of y. Yeah, for this exercise, your tables up to at least 13 or 14 should be thorough. Only then you can do this exercise quickly. Otherwise, you will take time calculating everything on a side. Yeah, but even if you take time, doesn't matter as far as you are doing it on your own and you are not cheating. Yeah, I substituted the value of y as 15. So 120 minus 30 by 5. So I get 90 by 5, 90, 100 and 120, correct. So 5 ones are 5, 4 40, so 18. So I get x as 18 and y as 15. How many hands go up, got this correct? Okay, good job. Guys, you will have done really a good job because this is not a tough exercise from the concept point of view. But yeah, from the point of view of calculations, slightly lengthy. Homework exercise 6A, you will be doing 2, 4, 8, 11 and 12. Rest of the sums, I am sure you must have done with the video along with me. How many of you are liking the video? Great job. Please go ahead, do your work on daily basis, don't keep anything pending and stay safe. Until the next video. Bye guys, take care.
Hope you had a lovely mathematics experience with the Rough Book, our learning companion.